We are here with Commander Helm from the 3rd District. Congratulations on your promotion.
Thank you.
So tell me, how does it feel to be the commander of the district where you first started your career with the police department?
It feels awesome. It feels very awesome to be come full circle, where to be the commander of a district where I started as a recruit. I didn't know anything 22 years ago, and here I am back now, and now I'm in charge, and it feels awesome.
Wonderful. And tell me some of the feedback you've been getting. We know that you've been meeting with religious leaders and community activists. What's some of the feedback that you've been getting from those people?
Well, everyone is ready to just hit the ground running and try to help and try to get some of this crime under control. We're looking forward to working very hard together. We've done marches, we've done summits, we've done community meetings, and everybody, every citizen is willing to not only just work with us, but they're willing to come out also, and that's a wonderful thing.
Oh, wonderful. Looking back, when you first joined the force in the community that you're now commander of, what differences do you see in the department as well as the community?
Well, there's a different, obviously things have evolved. There's a different generation of police officers. There are police officers now are younger than when I first came on the job. I was in my upper 20s, and now the officers are in their younger 20s. But there's also a difference in the people in the neighborhoods. Now that we have residents that have been in their houses for 30, 40 years, to the other end where new residents have been in their homes only 2 years. So the key is to put those two groups of people together so they can learn from each other. So the new homeowners can learn from the older homeowners to learn how to, what's needed in keeping up your property, what's needed in making friends with your neighbors, and what's needed in the whole community. But the whole, one of the biggest differences is the collaboration between everybody.
Good. And how long have you been on the force, and what year did you start?
I started in 1990, so this will be my 22nd year, and I've just been very blessed.
Wow, you don't look a day over 22. Okay, I have another question. This is a surprise question. A long time ago, I was talking to you, and we were at a concert with Kirk Franklin, and he said, he was talking about verbalizing your dreams, and he said, turn to the person next to you and tell them what your dreams are. So I turned to you, and I asked you what your dream is. Do you remember what you said to me?
Wow, was this the superintendent?
You said to me, I'm living it.
Oh.
And with that same smile, you said, I'm living it.
Oh.
And that moment was really inspiring to me, and it made me feel like, okay, if she's living it, I can live it too.
Oh.
What would you say to somebody who is struggling or trying to live that dream, doesn't look like it's going to happen? What's the key? How do you get to live your dream?
Oh, my goodness. The key is faith. Faith and hope. You have to believe. You have to believe it, and then you can receive it. But the key is faith. You can never give up on your dream or any aspirations that you think are totally out of your reach. You have to have faith. You have to just pray on it and name it and claim it. That's my sole belief. If you name it and claim it, it will be yours. And, your time is not God's time. It'll happen in whatever time is meant to happen. But in the interim, you're going to go through, so I just say keep the faith, hold on, and what's for you is for you, and it'll come to you.
Thank you so much, Commander Helm, for your time. I know you're busy. Thank you for taking a few minutes to share with us. And again, congratulations.
Thank you.